Okay. So, guys, we continue today with Divinity. Yesterday we... What did we do yesterday? Yesterday we met some trolls. We found a big monster which was too strong for us and we could not fight it. And... yeah, we were exploring more the woods, more or less. Then we talked to our god and we got some new skill, Vampiric Source skill. And then we were going to the eastern part from Driftwood, also off Driftwood, on the side. And there we found some elves. They told us we should help them to get Sehila, I think was the name, back. And she's like some kind of sawmill. And we went there, but then I was like picklocking a door, this door, and then we ended up in a fight. What I now thought about is maybe instead of like picking a lock and going inside, we could try to go around and maybe we can find a peaceful solution. I mean, not like I have to steal immediately everything. We can also maybe steal later. So I just want to see if we have there maybe, you know, a different approach, a peaceful approach maybe even. This should be empty. Oder? Ja, das ist mir hier. Hi, Grimborn. Ja, I was also like... the Elven's here? What happened? We found our way into the mill. Ach so. Okay, okay, okay. Again? I don't want to fight. Okay, okay, wait, wait, wait. I have to reload, guys. Sorry. I guess we have to go around, around, around. Maybe. I don't know why they're so aggressive. I did not do anything. I mean, the other time I was picklocking a door. I can understand that you may be angry about that. I mean, I also would not like that someone is just joining me here without asking. So I can understand that you're getting mad, but now I just did nothing. Okay, so let's try. I will go back this way and then we maybe try to go through the main entrance, oder? So maybe we need someone official to let us in. Oder? So let's save here now. Okay. So hier ist Poison. Oh. Uiuiui. Okay. This is like a warfield here, huh? Move. Come on. Okay. Oi. How many switches are here? Oh, there's a ghost.
Careful now.
Careful now. That's a trap.
The elf stands protectively over his corpse, eyes darting across the minefield.
Oh my God.
His gaze never quite falls on you.
Oh my God. Yeah, let's just speak to someone while we are burning. Good idea.
You are a warrior, proud and true. You saw your people die as the death fog consumed the forest. You heard them scream and then fall silent. You came for revenge, and you found your own death.
A lot of fire, yeah. It's a bit tough for me. I think I'm just really talented into getting burned. It's only been like 5 minutes today. Yeah, went fast that we burn, or?
Get away from me, you lone wolf tosser!
Tell me, no lone wolf?
Likely story, wolf. Go on, piss off.
Tell him to watch his mouth.
Else what? You lone wolves kick the shite out of me and send me into an accursed minefield where my cart gets blown up and I get killed and all you can do is laugh. What could you possibly do that's worse than that?
Sammy's lucky, don't show him what you can do.
Likely story, wolf. Go on, piss off.
Thunderfur is fluffy and it's very easy to burn. Yeah, I mean, there's nothing what I can do against it, oder? How many traps are here? Yeah. Yeah, some fire guys, it's fine. We're getting a bit warm, it's okay.
The elf spirit seizes you by the shoulders, but you feel nothing. His eyes are panicked, and he appears to be shouting something, but you can't hear him. He screams on, but with another's voice. An elven child, in terror and in pain. The fog, the fog, the fog! Those screams will never leave you, even after your death.
These are lone wolves. Let me do the talking.
Okay. Do we take Ivan? He said he wants to talk. So maybe the... Oh, right! Oh, I forgot. We don't have pants, guys. I forgot. We don't have pants and shoes. Maybe we can get here some pants and shoes in case they are peaceful. Need a fire emote? That would be funny, yeah?
The grim-faced guard raises his weapon as you approach, then stops short and quickly bows respectfully.
If and been missed, as I live and breathe. Didn't think we'd be seeing you again so soon, sir.
Not and ask the guard to remind you who he is?
You wouldn't remember me, sir. But you saved my life at Tambor Brook. I still have the anky where you stuck my big toe. He is. He'd be glad to see you, too. Glad as Roost gets, anyway. He's hoping you'll bring... friends.
He winks at you so hard and so theatrically that one whole half of his face seems to squint.
Roost's upstairs in the big house there, sir. He's waiting for you. Reckon he's as eager to hear how you've been getting on as the rest of us.
Okay. So, I guess that's inside. A burning panda? Yeah, that would be funny, oh? It would be funny. And maybe we could also, what we could do is we can think about that we do some changes with emotes so that I can maybe, you know, like switch out some again. That we could do, of course.
The spirit turns to meet your gaze. You feel heat upon your skin. The acrid stench of charring flesh assails your nose. And you can hear screaming. The agonizing cries of people burning alive. The spirit, mute, holds out his hand towards you, palm upwards in supplication, his eyes pleading. With a blast, the heat surrounds you. The hair on your forearm shrivels and dies. Flames dance across your vision, and the screaming seems to fill your very existence. And for a moment, you are the spirit before you. Your name is Cyrus Oates, and you are in a tavern with your friends. But someone has barred the exits and set the place afire. And you know that it's your fault. Your friends scream for help that will not come. You know that outside stands the lone wolf Pigsbane, and that he was paid to kill you. You know Pigsbane listens for your screams. All you can do is die proud. Your name is Cyrus Oates, and you will not scream.
As the heat rises, pull your hand away. Give the spirit's hand all the title.
Sweat streams from your pores. The roar of the flames drowns the screams. Cyrus Oates begins to burn. He does not scream.
Release the burning man's hand. Grip the spirit's hand and feel its pain.
You feel your flesh blister and char, your head crackle and burn. Cyrus Oates bares his teeth as his lips are burned away. But he does not scream.
grip the spirit's hands and his eyeballs begin to melt. Whew.
You try to close your eyes against the pain, but your eyelids have burned away. You haven't breathed in what seems like hours. You desperately want to scream. But Cyrus Oates did not scream.
Scream? I don't know.
Your mouth opens wide and you scream in horror, but no sound comes. The blackened bones that once were Cyrus Oates opens its mouth and starts to laugh. Then he releases your hand and you fall backwards, spinning, burning into the abyss, falling forever into your own soundless scream.
Oh, I'm burning!
Do I smell smoke?
Heat, burning flesh, the screams of the dying.
Botian is burning unexpected. Yeah, it's unexpected. Not only if the fire mode is dancing panda on fire. I'm not sure if I don't know if that's good visible, but maybe when it's possible. Okay, so let's see what we can do here.
A thin, grim man carefully sands the end of a beautiful, unpolished longbow. He studiously avoids looking up as you approach.
Hey, my name is Flame, how are you?
More in your way, sir.
Tell him he doesn't have the bearing of a lone wolf. Admire the bow. Ask if he has supplies that might interest an archer.
I'm not supposed to be trading with the other guests. Roost's orders.
You don't say anything?
Fine. Fine, just please be discreet. I'm very much at Roost's mercy while I'm here.
Oh! Arrow spray, ballistic shot, first aid, marriage. Targetsuck arrow. Shoot an arrow that goes straight, okay. Aber er hieß ein Helmet? Jetzt wird es für Finesse. Das could be cool. Get one Finesse and two Scoundrel. Inflict burning on contact. 70 physical, but it's a bit worse now. Okay.
Oh, it's you. Hello.
Tammy doesn't have the bearing of a lone wolf.
He looks from the ground to the bow and continues sanding.
Suppose I don't. I'm no assassin, just a Fletcher. Roost heard about my work and invited me to work here.
He blows a dusting of wood dust off the bow.
Feller doesn't ignore an invitation from Roost Anlon, does he?
Okay, it sounds like he got forced to go here. Yeah, I'm doing good, Manua Slam. Thank you very, very much. Oh, here's a ghost.
The sharpshooter turns from his silent watch over the mill and its approaches and holds you in a steady regard. An elderly mage glowers at the lone wolf sentry, muttering wordlessly.
Offer him a greeting?
He jerks his head to look at you, but says nothing. Then he opens his mouth, and you can clearly see the tip of a crossbow bolt protruding from the back of his throat.
Reach out, stick your fingers in his mouth, make as if you give the bolt and pull.
The spirit clutches his mouth in shock, and then realizes what has happened. He removes his hands, and the crossbow bolt is gone. He can speak once more, if painfully.
Thank you.
Ask him if there's anything more you can do for him.
He turns and points at the lone wolf sharpshooter.
Kill him.
How many ghosts are here? Oh? No? Also, this guy did kill a lot of people, right? Okay, what's that? Looks shiny. You can click on it, it's a lock.
A ghostly aura shrouds the log, along with a penetrating icy cold.
Place your hand on the log. Thank you for the follow. Good evening. I'm not sure if it's a good idea, but wait. Let me save and then we can try it out.
Bitter cold shoots up your fingertips, through your arm, shoulder, neck, and into your brain. Your whole body contracts with the aching freeze, and a voice sounds inside of you.
See what I see. Feel what I feel. Look down.
Okay.
Where your feet should be, you see great gnarled roots disappearing to a mossy forest floor. As this log once was, you are an ancestor tree. As you examine yourself, you see the top of a small elven child's head as she approaches. She wraps her arms around you and rests her head against your great trunk.
Remember with her.
You pass her a memory. Once, you were her father. You pass her the softness you remember of her chubby cheeks. You pass her the warmth between you when you curled back to back to sleep. A tear trickles from the child's eye and onto your bark. She whispers that she loves you. She says she will come back tomorrow.
You see?
The child departs, and night falls. You hear voices and the dull thud of axes. A human approaches you and pats your trunk. He raises his axe and...
You see?
You lie in pieces on the forest floor. Rough hands toss you into a cart and haul you away.
You see? You see what he does to me. You see he takes me from my life. You see he cuts me into parts. You make him pay.
Ask him where to find a culprit.
His bones lie buried in our sacred soil, but his spirit remains. Find him. Take from him what he takes from me. I show you where. Find him. I find peace then. I find peace when he is gone.
Oha. Oha. Hi, Prophet. You know that. Ay, ay, ay. But they seem to be have brought a lot of pain around the people, oh? Okay, let's see what's here.
He draws his wands.
You're in my space, stranger. Feel free to leave it.
The spirit of a woman locks her gaze on the lone wolf sentry.
Say my name, you son of a sow! E.D. Engrim! Say it! Say my name!
Okay, E.D.
And then, you are her. You are the young woman E.D. Engrim, seduced by a boy. But to become a lone wolf, he had to pass a test. He had to murder the woman he loved.
What?
He passed the test, and you were murdered. And all the time you knew him, he never spoke your name.
Oha. Oha. Hey, we'll see what you can do.
She turns to look at you at last.
I was E.D. Engrim. My killer should be made to speak my name.
Ay, ay, ay. Oh, yeah. Poor CP. It sounds like a terrible fate. No cookies. Okay. So here are some two ladies and also another ghost.
The whiff of chemistry assails you. You know that it's all in your imagination, but still your throat constricts, your stomach turns, and your vision swims before you. As your vision clears, the spirit is revealed, a lizard. He has eyes only for the lizard lone wolf who stands before him.
Note that he seems to haunt of his own kind, ask why.
He turns to you. He looks insane. He takes a deep breath and exhales. A cloud of greenish gas envelops you, and suddenly you are him. You're the Black Widowmaker, deep down in black shadows, setting your latest creation to paper. A deadly brew that looks and tastes like an elixir. It's your best work yet. You sip a celebratory tonic. And you realize you've made your last mistake. Your throat constricts. Acid burns your guts. Your heart slows to a halt. You slump forward. Akin appears, a lone wolf. She takes your book, but you're already dead. He intensifies his gaze on the lizard lone wolf before him. If looks were poison, she'd soon be dead.
You don't want to share the ice cream, Manoah's flame?
Looking fresh, gorgeous. What I wouldn't give to climb your tree.
An elegant lizard lone wolf smokes Drudeny through an ornate pipe.
Tell you, Vermemans like to know the secret of the Black Widow Maker's false elixir?
She turns one eye on you, raises the brow above it.
It wasn't I who switched his drinks. Besides, his death saved lives, so let's hear no more about it. Summing up, I can't help you, so get lost.
She puffs upon the pipe and blows the smoke towards you. When it clears, she's looking away again, as if you were never there.
Well. They have cookies? Okay, fair enough.
So tired.
This lone wolf doesn't seem to be really nice, though.
Laughter plays upon the lone wolf's spirit lips, but madness flashes in his eyes. His flittering gaze never quite comes to rest on you.
Hey, wanna have some fun?
Ask him what he has in mind.
A joke, of course. A prank, if you will. Tell Slumberjack here that Mudbarrow wants his money.
Okay.
You're not as dull as you look. Go on then. Tell him Mudbarrow wants his money back. It's a money back offer.
Him?
A lone wolf mage naps quietly. She talks in her sleep.
Laugh all you want, Mudbarrow. Madmen tell tales, and dead men's ghosts do not.
Whisper in her ear, Mudbarrow wants his money.
She turns towards you. When she opens her eyes, she's looking right at you.
Mudbarrow can't have his money. I hid it.
She closes her eyes and settles back to sleep.
Uh-huh, I know.
What are you waiting for? Tell the sleepy sourpuss.
I did.
She mutters in her sleep.
I never liked you anyway, Mudbarrow. You or your shite sense of humor. Don't think you haunt me, dead man. You or the Godwoken that we killed.
Search her for Mudbarrow's money.
What's that? Hey, that tickles.
She stretches, shifts position, but doesn't wake up.
You won't find nothing. Money's hidden on the beach by the water.
He slaps his thigh, tears of mirth rolling down his cheeks.
Tell him you will put the money to good use. Tell him you might just leave the money where it is. Ask him what he will do now.
Doubt crosses his face as he realizes he's stuck here forever and there are no more jokes to make.
Now?
Panic rises. And as the black shadow of eternity looms over him, he becomes hysterical.
Okay.
And what was once laughter is now an anguished scream. He returns to himself. The screaming stops. Both eyes settle upon you at last. He looks tired. He looks haunted.
Suggest she leaves for the Hall of Echoes.
But I've done such terrible things.
Present on terrible things.
He takes this in. A single ghostly tear trickles down his face.
I should go. Use the money well, if you take it. Do some good with it.
He raises a hand in salute and disappears.
Did we not already find money? Is it not this one, maybe? At the beach? I must go to have something special. That's totally true. Oha, a lot of traps.
The spirit of a paladin knight leans his head to one side, revealing the huge gash in his neck that nearly took his head off, and grins, a green glint in his eye. When he speaks, he whispers.
She's stronger than you know. Stronger than you know, boy, and faster too.
Is that he speaks from personal experience?
He launches one hand forward and, with a jolt, you are him. You're with Paladin Tom Hardwin, your best friend, on your way to arrest the notorious murderess known to all as Mummy Dearest. You find the dwarven lone wolf in a tavern at the bar. She doesn't look like much. You stand behind her. Tom Hardwin calls her name. The bar goes quiet. She doesn't turn, but you see her reach. You step forward to protect Hardwin as the axe comes around. In a moment, you're staring at the ceiling with Tom's hands pressing on your neck. A tavern wench is screaming, and Tom can't stop the blood. And through the panic and the tears, he puts his own price on the lone wolf's head. You just lie there thinking. She's stronger than you knew, and faster too.
Ask him if he knows how to gain an edge over Mummy Dearest.
He tilts his head once more, the great wound that killed him yawning open. He begins to laugh.
Off the top of my head? She's stronger than you know, and faster too. And here's the thing. She hates the wet. It makes her itch, and she makes mistakes. If only it would rain.
Who's the narrator? I don't know, said Buffer, but he's great, or? I think the narrator of the game is really fantastic.
A compact, heavily muscled dwarf turns from her training. She flicks her wrist, and instantly her axe, a stunning elven weapon, is a hair's width from your chest. The blade sings.
Ask if this was the axe that killed Paladin Everhard?
Everhard? Name means nothing. And anyway, I had nothing to do with it, nor did this axe. I took it from an elven raider a day or two ago.
Tell her she killed Evanhard and the order will pay handsomely for her head. Note the dried blood upon the blade. Tell her you want to trade.
Alright, we're done. Bugger off.
Here we have some pants. That's good. So here's no pants. 64. They're not special, but maybe better than nothing, I would say. And then he needs some shoes. Light boots. Oh. Do we miss anything else? A helm. A helmet. Physical armor. So, I mean, it's now not optimal that we have to buy something, but... yeah, who knows what will happen and who, when I will find, you know, when I want to have some specific items now, I will not get it anyway, right? So, yeah. The music is so great in this game.
She returns to her training.
No pants is the rule. Hello, Absol. Yeah, yesterday I put on some new gear, and I forgot that I'm using some kind of cursed set, and I can only, the set is only working if you have all parts together. Otherwise, you have some negative effects. Yeah, so I had to remove the pants and the shoes and the helmet. So, music can really make a game? Yeah, indeed. Indeed. I really don't know, said Buffer. I'm not really good remembering names, so I have no clue who's the narrator. So, but now we have some gear again. Okay. Okay. But this guy here, they seem to be overly mean, oder? I mean, all of them. All are mean. Here we have Void Vulcans. Oops. I'm happy to Fans are for weaklings. Achso. I have to open with him. No, you. Look out. I see a trap nearby. So. Careful now. Trap. Ah, yeah, yeah. How many traps are here? Oops. Fire here, fire there, la 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 la. Oh my god, many traps. Whew!
Careful now.
Burning! Where are my friends? Friends, can you move? It's just a little bit fire, come on. No! Oh no! Oh my god, guys, we have to reload. Oh no, oh no, oh no! Sir Laura died! No! Oh no! Sir Laura's died! Our little squirrel! Boomfire? Okay, we have to reload. I mean, he has to stay alive, right? Look at trap, run into them? Yeah, what should I do? I told you don't burn Sir Laura. He's not fireproof. Yeah, he's not. Okay, can we... Is that different? Ah, so maybe we can go this way or here. Is there also a door? Nee. But... I just wanted to go here because there's a treasure. Da. Like... Here? Naja. You can go there later. Happens in Baldur's Gate all the time. You use one fire spell. There's one random barrel and everything is on fire. Yeah. I think it happens for me all the time, regardless what I'm doing. I make rain and then it's everything is burning. It's not like that, but you know what I mean. I tend to have the talent to make everything burning. Oh, who are you? Hello.
The spirit of a young woman stares in blissful devotion at the lone wolf alchemist.
Piss off! Unless you got money.
You are really friendly.
Not likely anything you can afford. Right! Piss off!
Unfriendly people, oder? Can the real water banner make it burn? Yeah, I can. Everything will burn. We look at it and it's burning. Okay. Where do we have to go? They said the main building, right? Abandoned Livestock Mill, Lone Wolf Snake Root, Fletcher Corbin, Lone Wolf Deadeye, Lone Wolf Firewater. So is it going... So maybe here? In this building? We did not go there yet, or? Maybe here? Never knew you to be sentimental. Not sentimental. Unhappy people are. Yeah, I think they said we have to go upstairs. Okay, we safe?
I killed him slow.
Okay, we'll take, is it?
I do not care.
You think, Ivan?
He was like you. Imagine all.
A massive man looms over a small elf, his hair a tangle of matted knots. Scars upon scars cross every inch of visible flesh, from his hands to his gnarled face.
Well, I think it's the lady from the island, oder? Yeah, I think this is the seer lady.
He slurps something into his mouth, thoughtfully chews for a moment, then spits it on the ground, where it lands with a sickly splat.
It don't work. For me, anyway. You try.
He offers her something round and slippery, like a wet, white marble in the palm of his hand.
I do not defile the dead.
And you an elf?
We eat flesh to honor it, not to steal the secrets of the dead.
Secrets, secrets, they're no fun. Secrets, secrets, hurt someone.
Ifan clears his throat. Roost turns his face to you both and roughly wrenches the elf's jaw towards you as well.
Well, look at that, elf. The silver claw is back. Ifan, old boy, you're losing your bloody touch. Your mark, Alexander, still draws breath. And my sources tell me he's headed somewhere called the Nameless Isle. I'll be setting sail there myself any day now to take him out. Your failure has put the reputation of all wolves at stake.
Okay.
But I suppose I might be swayed to forgiveness by the other little godwoken morsels you've brought me.
Stay away from the godwoken roost. They're mine.
Step up to Roost and demand to know who issued the godwoken contract. Step back and let Ifan handle this. Yeah.
Ifan steps between you and Roost, head high and hands wide.
I can't let you take them, Roost. You know me. You know you can trust me. So believe me when I say this is bigger than any contract.
That's not how it works. Let the rest of the world worry about right and wrong, good and evil. We've always had a narrower focus, and that's not about to change now. We've had good times, Ben Mezd. We've had bad times, but this is the best time of all. You just dancing a contract right into my lap. What else are friends for?
Roost moves to lunge at you, but Ifan is quicker. With two steps and three stabs, he slows Roost down just long enough for you to draw your weapon.
Oh, we have to fight? Whew. There are a lot of wolfies.
A new follower.
Thank you for the follow. Good evening. Oi. He's level 14. Okay, so let's go, guys. Let's go! Make some good fighting and stabby. And pew pew! So, let's go. So, we buff ourselves. Oh, blood arrows. Okay. Okay, that was not bad, or? Oh no, she's knocked down. Ah, mini. Everything is aflame in 5. I can make fire now if I want. Yes, I could. Okay, so we make. So, he's knocked down. No fire. Reactive shot. Not sure what it's doing. So we call our wolfy friend. Woo! Now our wolfy is not so big. Then we encourage everyone. You can do it. You can bite him. No. And bite again. No. Why did he not bite him? Okay. Neues Auto-Turn. So. Shoot again, the enemy. So now it's Prince's turn. We do a blitz attack. And then we can do sicko fight. They're shooting me, they missed. Oh, this little kid, do you see that? Spirit of a little girl. I make a whirlwind attack. Boom! That was really good. So now let's make here, toss them down. Ha! Wow, they give so much XP. Okay, now we can make a summon at last. We get a totem. Good job. So now it's your turn. Bleeding. Yeah. And then you can walk here. So we can as next then attack the ranged guys. Our wolfie eats the wolf. The wolf is called Lord. Lord and Lady. Oh, no, we missed. Ah, too bad. Oh, we forgot to call Condor. Here, Condor. Oh wow. Good. I attacked him even so the path was interrupted. Can't reach destination. Wieso? Can't we attack him? Can't go through the ghost? This looks weird, or it looks like a black mirror. It looks like a portal or something. Oh, where's he going? Oh, nice. So two hits just for walking. So now we can make some fire. Okay. And now we can do a crippling blow. Oh, no? Buff ourselves. Okay. We are here. Take a fight. And we can buff ourselves, yeah. We can do crippling blow. Oh wow, this was almost death with one hit. Aye, that was strong. That was really, really strong. I make a fire totem. Then got my own countdown. No problems. Oh, there's another kid. You see that? Here. There are little boys, a girl, little kids here. Can't reach. Ha! Can I shoot him? How can we attack this? Maybe you can port him out. I think that's a good idea. Port him out. Shoot again. Oh, he's almost dead. Hit him. Boom. Level up. We got all level up. Yeah. But Arthur, didn't he get two hits already around 4? Yeah. I don't know. Okay. He killed me! Whoa! There's just one dude left and he killed me? Oh.
I'm ready.
Unbelievable. Okay. So, we heal him. So. Now we make teleport. We take him. And we teleport him here between us. So. The other one died now because we let him fall. And we buff him, the ranged guy. Hello, Garrett! So. Shoot on him. Oh, come on, 15 HP! Can you hit him? There we go. Ta-da! That was close that we died there. Okay. So, how are you doing, Garrett? Let's see. First we do level up. Okay. We got... So do we need skills? Wait, I have to check before we do anything. We have to see if we need any skills. Bone cage. Pin down. Oh, I could even put a skill in. Blinding radiance. Now this one do so. Okay, she has so many spells. Uncanny evasion. She has many spells, it's just so many, it's just like don't even know what to use. Every wind, shocking touch. Shoot a stunning bolt of lightning that forks. Oh, this is, could be cool. And maybe we give her 1 point. He could use one more skill, then we can use the shield for ranged attack. He can have this one. Okay, so we do finesse, and then we make memory wits. Okay, we do wits. So then we have Huntsman. Then we got available, we have one more talent. So what can we do? Bigger and better, bigger and bigger immediately grants you 2 extra attribute points to spend. Shooting arrows will inflict bonus elemental damage depending on the surface the target is standing in. What the wash? Walk it off. Unstable. Botanist. Okay. We just take. Oh yeah, I think we take bigger and bigger, better. So, we have 2 more points. We can make this one. Then make 1 memory in case we get a nice spell. So, okay. So, he gets memory and intelligence. Let me give her. Hi Skyuko, how are you doing? Good to see you. I hope you're doing fine. Thank you so much for joining. And thank you so much for your help. Thank you very, very much. So we give him we can't do summoning. If he has 3, maybe we go then Utrosophist. And okay, so what do we to take with her? We have this stuff with the skills. Cost of using grenades and scrolls. Comeback kit. Lost action points, cost of spells by 1 when standing in surface of same element. Allows you to flee combat. Get the food and poisons. Fire at maximum vitality, hot head grants you extra critical chance and more accuracy. A character of Ice King has extra water resistance but takes more fire. Okay. Leech heals when standing in blood. Oh, I have no clue what's good. Bye bye, Manoa's Flame! Ah, so. Oh, Lord, I thought you'd go away. Sorry. Nix! Sorry. I misread. I thought you'd go away. What a rush. What is good, guys? I have no clue what to take. Answer makes you explode? Nee. Certain status calls you are no longer blocked. Stench decreases everyone's attitude towards you by 25. Petpole, Parrymaster, Watching. Perform attacks of opportunity. When resurrected, you resurrect full health. Oh, that would be good. Gives you 3 extra points in your memory attribute. That would be good, or? Is this a new game? No. Divinity, original Divinity Sin 2 is released since 2017. And the first one was, I think, 2015 or something. Or 2014? I don't remember. But they're both really, really good. Really, really nice. This one. If I understood it correctly, she should have now more memory slots. Yeah. A lot. That's good. For her, I need a lot of spells. So, but it's a really, really good game, Skyuko. So this guy's Larian Studios, they also made Baldur's Gate 3, which is at the moment in early access. Oh, okay, so we take for him now. So strength. And we need skills for him. Can we take for him a warfare? We have now 10. Ah, so now is the question, what should we do as a second then? When we have that already. So we take for him then this one, and then we can give him wits and strength. Oh, we could also give maybe constitution, or okay, maybe next time. Don't forget. Okay, so what should we give him? Geomancer increases all poison and earth damage you deal and any physical armor restoration you cause. Achso, he is also fire. Und Gear plus 2. Should we give him fire? Gives all fire damage to deal. Special. Okay, maybe give him fire? Yeah, let's go. He will be fire, dude. Yeah, we give him fire. Because it's anyway fire. I make him fire. It'll burn. Because it seems like we need sometimes a fireball or something, so they can make him fire. So, Red Prince, he's anyway red, so he will be fire. She is summoner and makes wind and water. She makes everything. My guy, I would like to do polymorph, maybe. Maybe, I'm not sure about that, but maybe polymorph, because it sounds so cool. Or we give polymorph to him, because he is his wolfie. What do you think, guys? Who should get polymorph? Should we go polymorph with Ifan or with the archer? Not sure if polymorph is good for archer, because maybe close range makes more sense, maybe. I don't know. Okay, so we go. Here's this one. Then we can give him animators. And off carpet launch, you can archer with poly can get spider legs, don't it? I don't know. So you can always have high ground. What is spider legs? Can you then walk over everything? I mean, I have a jump with my archer. We have tactical retreat. I can teleport to any position, so I can also jump up or on high ground if I want. Okay. We take with him then. Wits. Strength. And then we take warfare is now. Okay, we make warfare on 10. Okay. He can climb walls. Ah, okay. Yeah, I'm not sure. I mean, I have to just think about what we go next, because now I have the most of the stuff I have now leveled up here, so maybe we can go something else. Or we go scoundrel, because scoundrel gives you more crit with my archer. It could also maybe work. Maybe. Yeah, we will see. We will see, but difficult. We have to think about it. What we go next? But just remember, remind me if I forget it. So fire is Red Prince, yeah. So in case I do something wrong again. Okay, so let's first we loot. Shield, chest, belt, and the parchment. So we got by request of the Divine Order, certain sorcerers known as Godwoken are to be identified upon the agreement of both parties to the terms of this contract. These Godwoken will be located by the contractor and disposed of it in a timely, quiet, and seemly manner. Due to the nature of this contract, new names may be given on an ongoing basis. The amount of claimable per name is fixed at 10,000 gold per head, to be paid immediately upon receipt of evidence of the task completion. What do they have to send? Heads? Or what? It sounds like they have to bring the head over. And how do they know if it's a Godwoken?
Devil? The contract seems to predate Alexander's ascension, too.
Okay. Oh, I'm
too
heavy.
You made the bad man go away. You did it. He can't hurt me now.
The child smiles a ghostly gap-toothed grin and waves goodbye.
Yeah, I don't want to know what he did to him. We got a magical shield. Oha. I mean, the left one seems to be a bit better because we have one strength. And we deflect. But this one has almost twice of armor. So we just take this one. Yeah, I will just send it to the, I don't know, Red Prince because it's so heavy. So identify. We got a new chest armor. This is finesse. Oh, it's for us. Oh yeah, two intelligence, one huntsman. Inflicts poison on contract. Naja. If someone wants to cuddle with us, not so good idea. Not a good idea if they want to cuddle. Okay. So. Then we got a belt. Thievery, leadership, dodging. 27 physical armor. Ay. What kind of crap do I have on my character? Okay, but. He's also thievery. Lost leadership. Yeah. Here we get the, he gets this one. And he can have this one. But initiative is good. It's not so much more. I will just hold on that one. And you can have. No. And you? No. Oh. Okay. You are just going away. And. Okay. Good. Oh, I'm still too heavy. I'm still too heavy. Wieso? Okay. What do I have on me? What is so heavy? They collect something specific? Oh, wait, what does it do? Shackles of pain. I have some body parts on me. We can eat.
You are running through a barren landscape. Brambles and weeds scratch at your ankles. Your heart is pumping acid, but you can't stop. Something catches you around the chest and you fall. The rough ground scrapes burns into the flesh of your bare arms, your knees, your face, you as you skid to a stop. Footsteps approach. That's the Scion, a rough voice calls. Kill him.
Okay. So?
You are a young elf, very young. Still, the memories of eons dance inside you. You watch them like a play behind your eyelids. You are asleep in your family home when Roost's people steal in like a plague. A hand over your mouth, a hurried journey through the forests. You won't tell Roost how to find the others. The end comes quick.
It sounds like the lone wolves are really bad. I did not know that they're really such bad guys.
He's gone. I guess this means I can leave. I hope the next place is better. This was a bad place. Bye, and thanks. If I could give you the biggest hug in the world, I'd give you the even bigger one. I love you.
I don't even want to know why he's so little kid.
The spirit's chest heaves in short, hard bursts. His face is pinched into a tight sneer, fists balled up at its sides. It falls to its knees and grabs its matted hair in two fists, then rips. The spectral mats break away and reappear.
But Jimmy can't hurt anyone now, not even himself. Say if he's done carrying on, you need him to answer some question.
Shove your questions. Swallow nails, you.
Ask him who gave him the contact to kill Godwoken.
He catches a string of spittle with the back of his hand and wipes it away as a malevolent grin spreads over his face.
God did. Do us all a favor and go die.
Do you need to know who ordered him to kill Skyans?
Does it matter? They won't stop. Not till they're all dead. You can be sure of that. They ain't what you think. They'll do anything to survive. You'll get what's coming to you. The good guy. Everyone's their own good guy.
He scratches at his scarred face with spectral nails, digging deep grooves that instantly vanish.
No. No, no.
Yeah, we just let him here. I will not help him. What's this?
The surface of the mirror ripples with a sickly haze. As you gaze into its surface, the haze forms shapes, and the shapes jerk into a figure. You see the outline of a skull, perhaps once an elf, though the flesh is all but rotted from his bones. What remains is the flat, dull color of sick. Behind him march ornately clad black ring. The picture flickers, fades, then returns in full relief. Beneath the din of the marching soldiers, or perhaps alongside it, a voice snags in your mind, like a fishhook in an open eye. It makes a demand. Tell it if you killed another Godwoken.
Ask who you're talking to? Him, no?
The image strains and flickers again. Each time it comes into focus, a dull ache squeezes your head like a vice, tighter, tighter, unbearably tight. The image flickers and fades to a hazy sheen once more, and the pressure vanishes.
A rare prey. Oh my god, look how many quests we have. We have so many quests, it's not even stopping. A rare prey. Don't see anything. In this offer. All the family. Okay, whatever. I don't see it. Okay, let's talk to her. Also, we have to talk to our friends.
There's no denying what you saw. The Black Ring itself is hunting you. Or at least, paying others to do so. It's impossible to tell who might be working for them. You eye your companions.
Let him come for us. I know who my two allies are. We knew Roost was an enemy, but the next person in the Black Ring pays off may not be so obvious.
Man's best friend is his sword. His only friend to boot.
Well, as a lone wolf with a standing contract to kill Godwoken, I trust you.
Life's full of surprises. That's what makes it fun and horrifying.
Okay. Oh, welcome back, CP. Yeah, he is that buffer, I agree. Okay, let's see. Black Mirror. Claws. Fifty physical armor, just from a shirt. Not bad.
I know you come for me again. I know you do. I know I only have to wait.
Because you see the future. Ask if she's alright. Quickly undo her binds. We should get out of here before more lone wolves show up. You alright?
I am fine. I am fine when I return to my people.
Ask how she escaped from Fort Joy.
My people come for me. My mother, Sarius, the others. They take me away from there. But then the wolves come. Roost Anlon. He takes me and they cannot stop him.
Okay.
Do we return now? To the others? My people wait for me nearby.
Yes, you met your people and promised to return her to them.
Yes, thank you. I see you so clearly. I see the goodness in you. Let's go.
Before leaving the room, you might want to save again. Okay. Okay, Elven Seer. Schieße was? Okay. So, make a big save now. And a normal one. Okay, so did I miss something? Oh, there's a chest. I almost did not see the chest. Kidnapping contract, panties, assassination contract. Okay, we can take this one. This one. You can find a girl in Fort Joy. Move quickly. I have certain sorcerers are being transformed into sorcerer slaves. No doubt the Siren would make a tempting candidate. Kill her cleanly, but not before extracting every morsel of useful information from her. The more signs you destroy, the heavier you find your pockets. You can collect your payment from me or the Nameless Isle. Get one of your other little marks to show you the way. Shadow Prince. Pact neutralization. Subject Godwoken. The master agrees to your request, Wolf. Should your word be as abiding as you claim, then you have nothing to fear from the Black Ring. The task is simple. Eliminate Godwoken, including Lucian Spawn, should the Weasel make a squeak. We won't dictate your methods, nor will we reveal our motives. Extermination is your only concern. The Black Ring does not tolerate failure. Payment will be offered immediately upon proof of fulfillment. What happened to the ghost girl? To the kids, we were here. I talked to them. So there were like three kids. And I talked to them and they were all saying they are happy that they can go now. And then they disappeared and went on to the halls of echoes. And the one little boy said, this guy is evil. I come back, said Buffer. But yeah. We freed the souls. Okay, I save. Oh, just have to bring it back. Oh! Oh. Oh! Okay, I guess they're angry. Did they hear us fighting or what? Okay, maybe we made some noise by fighting, huh? Could be the case. Okay. And the good thing is, we will get a lot of XP for fighting, oh? Target is too far. One. Maybe the flames gave you away? Ah, so. No, you got the prisoner. Ah, so. Yeah, okay. Ah, so. Yeah, makes sense. And she has to stay alive? Oh! So they will attack her? Oh yeah, that sounds difficult to fight and that she's staying alive. Walking corpse. She can also do something. Sucker punch. An unexpected blow that deals damage. Original magic armor for allies around the caster. And she can heal. Strong? Not bad. Good job. Okay. It's too far away. Can we jump there? No? Okay, let me just walk here. How could we miss? He's lying on the ground. No? I I mean, it's really hard to miss when he's lying on the ground and not moving, or? Okay. Here we summon. Ice? Oh, I thought he's this poison. Oh. It's like falling and missing the floor. Exactly, Sky, yeah. Naja, good. I will try that she's not dying. I guess that's a good idea. Can we... How far can she walk? Oh. Ay, ay, ay. Okay. Here? So I can't attack. Okay. That's Kondo's turn. Can't he attack? Can't reach? Oh. Good job. So maybe we can... Ah, see, they're walking around. I thought when I put there my summons in front that they maybe focus a little bit on them. Okay. The cripple did not work. Arthur Dent. What is Arthur Dent, Garrett? Maybe I have to heal her, huh? Oh yeah, maybe. Okay, so we are here. So. Pretty good hit. Hey, how many enemies are here? They're all coming to us. Ui, 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 ui. Oh, that's the... That was the alchemy guy. Okay, can we? Can't move, I'm crippled. Okay. Bye bye, Manoa's Flame, have a great day! Thank you very much for joining. Target is too far. We buff the lady. So. Okay. So can you bite her? Go again. Good job. So you can hit her. Okay, one is down. Okay, now it's my turn. Slumbot Jack. Ah, that was the one with the treasure, right? he scribbled now? The Rupert Road. How many enemies are there? The entire camp? Yeah, it looks like that. They're really a lot. They're really angry with us, huh? Did I forget to put the shield on? To shoot? Okay, he's down. Burn here. Then we can make... I can buff her, or we make a shield around her. So I do fortify around the lady. Okay. Okay, so she's dead. Have a nearby character or totem, including self. Okay. How could he toss it inside? Here's a roof, or? Or did he just... I don't know. How can he toss anything here inside? Cheater. What did he do there? Oil blob. What? Are you crazy? Ay, ay, ay. Anti magic armor for allies around the cast. Also, I can't do it now. Cane Stitch, fully restore target's character's magic armor. Nee. Okay, you can make rain here, maybe. So. Okay. So. Okay, she's coming from this side, right? So we make. Here. A totem. And she can maybe go here. So Wolfie, you can eat this one. Okay, we have no turn anymore. I wanted to go with him around so we can go attack this dude here. This alchemy guy. Can you shoot him? One more. Oh, come on. 20 HP. Ah. So. Can we jump there? Maybe I just go here. Then we can put our shield up. Okay. Come on. Oh no, she can jump. No. Ay, 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 ay. Ay, 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 ay. Oy, this was not good. All in. Phoenix dive. Oh no. I was blocked. Oh. I was just running on a pillar. Oh, where did he port her? He port her outside? Oh nein! Oh, I thought she's safe here, but he port my little lady away. Oh. Okay. Can you come here? Just come to me. Come a bit closer. Oh yeah. Oh, that's mean. Okay. Where's she going? Also. Okay, so now we attack you. Oh no! Oh, I missed. Can I teleport him? Choose a target teleport. Mixie, thank you so much for the raid. How are you doing? Ah, out of sight, okay. Thank you very, very much. I'll be doing fine. Good evening. So. Okay, how many guys do we have still? You can go outside. So you can maybe help. And Condor can also go help. Okay, now we shoot. Good. You can attack him. So, then we have to stop the turn. Oh! Oof. Oh, this sharpshooter. Oh no! Critical hit. Oh nein! Enjoy your meal, Mixie. Thank you so much for joining us and for the raid. Oh oh. Oi, oi, oi. Oh oh. Hello, Tio. How are you? Good evening. Peace him. Chloroform. He's like drinking a lot of alchemy potions. Okay, now it's my turn. Okay. Ah yeah, this lady is strong like crazy, oh. Target ally character is guaranteed to land critical hits with basic attacks and weapon skills, but is muted. Crippling blow. Boom. So she's crippled. Maybe we can kill her even? Okay, she's done. Oh no no no, don't kill the lady please. Is the alchemist after all? Yes, he is. How are you doing to you? Everything alright? Oh, oh. Oh. Stop it. Stop. Oh, Sheila. Okay, okay. So, Sheila, we have to heal a bit. Okay. And then you maybe can you go here? Ah, so she's crippled. She's crippled. Okay, wait, but I can take a potion, no? Or can she? She can't, I think. Maybe I can port her. Thank you for the follow. Ooh. Oh no. Okay, wait. So Lose, can you? Target is too far. No. Can you port her? Take her and bring her over to me. Guess today's stream will take at least until midnight with you fighting the whole camp. I think we just save now and then we continue next time. Because this fight seems to... Oh, I don't know. I mean, we have left. I think this four. Oder? But yeah, it can take a while. I think this is this guy, and this guy. And then we have to loot also. And this guy. Oh, oh. We can do that too? Yeah, we could also just save and then continue tomorrow, on Friday. Things going great on my new job. Everyone speaks English, even so I still need to learn German. I became friends with my coworker and I got my own apartment now. Yeah! How is the new apartment to you? Looks pretty fun. I never played a turn-based video game. It's really well made, Skyhooker. So the turn-based aspect in this game is really fluent. And here everything works together. So for example, you can, let's say if there's water on the ground and you make an electricity spell, then everything will be on fire, also on electricity, like bzzz. And so physics are a little bit included and stuff like that. It sounds like a really better start now to you. I still need to move. I get the keys next week, but I signed a contract already. Yeah, that sounds wonderful. And it's a long time, we still need to talk all the ghosts. Yeah, I think we're safe now. It's probably better. I don't want to now rush it. So we're safe. And then we continue tomorrow. The next day with the fight. Tomorrow we have movie evening. But yeah, I can really highly recommend this game in case you never played it. Check it out. Also the first one. So Divinity Original Sin 1 is also good. And the games before, I did not really play it, but Logan said they're also nice. Yeah. If I would have known the fight would be so long that everyone is angry on us, then would probably have said we don't start it today. But naja. You again, my friends. Yeah. Thank you so much for joining, Theo. Have a good night. And I'm glad everything is now going better for you and that you found also some friends. So. But yeah, next time then we can then, you know, in peace, complete the fight and also get some. All the loot, and yeah, we have to speak with the ghost also, how you said. So, it'll be great. So, so tomorrow evening, guys, we have our movie evening, which we do every 2 weeks. And the people voted on Discord that we watch Independence Day. So if you have Amazon Prime, or you have, you know, on a different platform, the movie, you can join us if you like to. Great film. Yeah, I did not see it for a long time. I've been looking forward to see it again. It's always fun. And I really like Will Smith. So, the movie is great. So, thank you so much, my friends, for the wonderful evening. As always, you are amazing. Thank you very, very much. Have a good night, Theo. Good night, Alien. Buonanotte. Good night, Fuzzy Louie. Sweet dreams, Selena. Good night, Sabine Tamir. Don't forget to get your snacks for tomorrow. Good night, Scout Finch. Good night, Inaya. Sleep well and sweet dreams. Good night, Zed Buffer. Good night, Kili. Sleep well. Have a good night. Good night, Skyhooker. Thank you so much for joining. Good night, Garrett. Good night, everyone. Good night, Kyvern. Good night, Elmama Dragon. Good night, Curse the Reaper. Thank you so much, my friends. Have a good night. Sleep well and sweet dreams. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Tschüss. Toodles. Good night.